So now we move to question number 7. That is, how many four-letter words can be formed using the word ineffective? So we have to form different four-letter words using the alphabets of the word ineffective. So let's proceed to the solution.
These are the type of problems in which we have n objects and we have to take r at a time when all objects are not different.
Okay.
Now what do you mean by all objects are not different? We can explain this by the question only. The question has the word ineffective. And ineffective has 11 alphabets, and ineffective can be written like we can write it as we have 3 E's, 2 F's, 2 I's, C, T, N, and V.
So there is repetition of the alphabet E, F, and I, so we can say that all of them are not different.
Yeah, all of them are not different. So in these type of cases, in these type of questions, we have to make cases. We have to make cases on the basis of alike items together. Otherwise, we end up getting wrong answers.
Okay.
So, and basically, there is no fixed formula for these type of questions. So, there is no other way rather than making cases. So, we start making cases by saying that we make cases on alike basis. Making cases like 3 alike items together and 1 different.
So total count to 4. So this is a case, valid case.
Now the second case can be 2 alike items together and remaining 2 are also alike. The third case can be 2 alike items together and 2 different.
So basically the idea is that you have to make all the different possible cases in which you can choose a 4-letter words from the word.
And the fourth, can be all different. So we have made cases to make sure that we don't miss any of the permutation. And starting with our first case, is 3 alike and 1 different. So how do we calculate this case, like the number of ways to get words in which 3 alike items are there and 1 is different? So while seeing this question, we can see that getting 3 alike items, for getting 3 alike items, we have only one possibility. Like if we select E's, all 3 E's, then only we can get 3 alike items. So we have only one way to get 3 alike items. That's 1C1.
Okay.
And for 1 different, we have to select one alphabet from the remaining 6 options. The 6 options are F, I, C, T, N, V. Out of these 6, we have to select one. So we can select it in 6C1 ways. Now we have selected the 4 alphabets. Now we have to arrange them. The number of ways to arrange 4 alphabets is 4 factorial. But now we see that we have 2 alike items, 3 alike items in it. So we have to divide it by 3 factorial to ensure that there are no repetitions.
So basically the idea is you are forming words, so first you have to select them, and the arrangement is also to be considered as you are forming the words.
Yeah, arrangement is very important, because when we are talking about words, we have to see arrangements. That's why permutation is mentioned in PPC 8. So moving forward, we solve the second case. The second case is 2 alike and 2 alike. 2 alike and 2 alike.
So proceeding the similar way, we will do this case also.
For 2 alike and 2 alike, basically we have 3 possibilities: taking 2 E's, taking 2 F's, or taking 2 I's. So we have to select 2 out of these 3 possibilities. We can select 2 of the out of these 3 possibilities.
What are the 3 possibilities?
The 3 possibilities are basically E, F, and I's. We can take because only these are the 3 having 2 or more alphabets.
Okay.
You cannot have 2 C's, because ineffective word does not have 2 C's. Okay. So we have 3C2 ways to select two alike and two alike items, and then we can arrange them in 4 factorial and by 4 factorial upon 2 factorial into 2 factorial ways.
Right.
How does this term come? This term is basically comes by the formula that when we have P plus Q items where P are alike and Q are alike,
okay,
the number of ways to arrange them is P plus Q factorial upon P factorial into Q factorial.
So by this formula we see that the number of ways to arrange two alike and two alike items are 4 factorial, that is the 2 plus 2 equals to 4, that is n, and divided by the different alike items together, that is 2 factorial into 2 factorial.
Now we move to the third possibility. The third possibility is that we have two alike items and two different items. For this,
so now we'll proceed fast because we have seen how to select and how to arrange them. So we'll move somewhat fast. And
so moving for selecting two alike items, we have three possibilities and we have to select only one of them, because we only two are alike. So out of these three possibilities E, F and I, we select one, and then for two different we have remaining 6 possibilities. So out of 6 we select 2, and now as we have selected the 4, we have to arrange them. So we arrange them in 4 factorial by 2 factorial ways, like, because it has two alike items as done before. Now moving to the last case has the last case is that we have all different. This is quite a simple case because we have directly 7 possibilities, that one can be from E, F, I, C, T, N, V.
Okay.
So out of these 7 we have to select 4. So for the last case, when we have to select all different, we can say that we can select it in 7C4 ways, because we have 7 possibilities, and then for arrangement we can multiply it by 4 factorial.
Okay, so we don't have to divide it by anything. We don't have to divide it by anything because here all the items are different.
Exactly, we have selected all the items differently, so we don't have to divide it by anything.
Okay.
So we can get the total number by adding all these. So that will be the total number of ways to get to get all the 4-letter words that can be formed using the word ineffective.
So we have seen that how to solve the question in which we have to permutate n objects taken r at a time when all of them are not different. So now we'll move to our next question. So now we move to question number 8, that is, in how many ways can a child select 5 balls from 5 red, 4 black, 3 white, 2 green and 1 yellow ball, and it is given that the balls of same color are identical. So we see that this question is similar to the previous question, in the sense that in this we have to just select r objects from n objects where all the n objects are not different, and in previous question we have to permutate them also. So now let's proceed to the solution.
For the solution of this question, we have to take care that in this question we don't have to make permutations, we don't have to arrange the objects. But this question is slightly different in the sense that in these kind of questions we can have a formula, we can derive a formula, but it is not safe to derive a formula because there are many possible errors one can make. So we'll do it logically only, and this question also helps us to think how different cases can be made. Like in the last question we had only 4 cases, but in this question we will be having many other cases also. So this question is good in the sense to know how to think of the cases. So let's
move to the solution.
Yeah, let's move to the solution. For the solution of this question, we have to select 5 balls, and we have the option of selecting 5 red balls. We have 5 red balls, 4 black balls, 3 white balls.
There are 4 black balls, I think.
Oh, I'm sorry. 4 black balls, 3 white balls, 2 green balls and 1 yellow ball. So these are the possibilities the child can choose. Okay. So now when we move to making cases, we have to be careful. what are the cases? The first case can be all alike. This wasn't the case in the last question because we didn't have enough balls. We didn't have enough balls so that we could have all alike. So now we have all we can have all alike items because we have five red balls and one has to select five balls.
Okay.
So we have we can have a case of all alike. The second case can be four alike and one different. That makes up to five. The third case can be three alike and two alike. This is also a case, three alike and two alike, because it is possible that you take three balls of the same kind and other two of the same kind. The fourth case can be two alike and one different.
So this is similar to the previous question. In the same way, we have to make all the cases provided and we have to take care of the thing that no case is mismatched.
The next case can be two alike and three different.
Okay.
And our last case is all different. So did we miss any case? Yes, we did miss one case. The case we missed was three alike and two different.
So you can see that you have to really take care of that you made all the cases, because you can miss. It is very easy to miss cases, but you have to take care of that.
So let's start computing the solution for case one. Case one is all alike, and we can see that we have only one possibility of choosing five all alike, which is five alike, which is actually five red balls. Otherwise, we don't have any other case. So we have only one way of selecting all alike. And now we know that we don't have to actually arrange them. So the only answer for the first case is one. Now moving to the second case, in the same way, we can say that four alike and two for one different. We have only two possible ways. Either I can have four black balls or I can have four red balls. So we say that for the second case we have 2C1 ways to select four alike.
Okay.
Because we had two possible groups. Either it could be selected from the group of red or it could be selected from group of black. So we can select in 2C1 ways, and for the rest one different, we have an option of white, green, yellow and one of red or black. So we have four ways. So we do it in 4C1 ways,
and we don't have to arrange them.
Yeah, we don't have to arrange them. Then in the third case, similarly, we can solve the third case, that is three alike and two alike. For three alike, we have three possibilities: red, black and white, and we have to choose one of them. So we have 3C1 ways, but now we have to select two alike items also. So for the two alike, we see that we have three options: black, white and green. The addition of green, option of green, is really important, because you can also get two alike items from green. So the number of possibilities are three. So again, we have 3C1 ways.
So basically, you have to be careful in this case, because you see that when you have chosen the one item, in choosing the rest of the one, you need to be careful.
The next case is two alike and one different. For two alike and two alike, we have four options for choosing two alike items, and we have to choose two out of them, because we need two groups of two alike items. So we can say 4C2 for selecting two groups, and for the remaining one, how many do we have? we can choose one yellow, we can choose one green, we can choose one white, assuming that only black and red were selected. So we have three options. So out of those three, I can select one.
Okay.
Moving to the next part. The next part is two alike and three different.
So basically, we will proceed in the similar manner and write the cases for all of the computation formula for all of the cases.
Now, we have reached to our last case, the case of all different. The all different, when we consider all different, how many options are possible? We can take one from red, we can take one from black, we can take one from white, we can take one from green or from yellow.
So in total there are five options.
No, there is one option, because you have to select one from each. There is only one option of selecting them. So for all different case, you have only one way of selecting them, because you have to select each ball once. So when we are talking about all different balls, you have to select one ball each, and thus we have only one option. And now we come to the last part, three alike and two different. For three alike, again, we have how many ways? We can either select red, black or white. So three ways. And for the rest, two different. How many ways will be there? We'll have four possibilities. So what will be the answer? That will be 4C1 that will be 3C1, because we had three possibilities.
Okay.
And for two different we had four. Yes, we had four possibilities for three different.
So 4C2 ways.
So 4C2 ways. And we sum them up to get the final answer, and keep in mind that we don't have to arrange them.
I think one is being rubbed by you.
Yeah, plus one for all different. Plus one is for all different. So when we write the final answer, we have 1 plus 2C1 into 4C1 plus 3C1 into
3C1. So basically we'll sum all the cases to get the final answer. So in this problem, we see that it is very similar to the previous problem. Only thing is that in this, they are the cases are really very good, and we have to take care of them.
So this is how we proceed to the questions in which we have many cases. So basically, this question shows how you can form cases and how to keep in mind that when to arrange objects and when not to arrange objects. Because one can get confused in the previous question and this question whether to arrange them or not. So keep in mind of arranging them or not arranging them.
So now we have learned the technique of solving the problems in which we have to select our objects from n objects, where all n objects are not different. And now in this we'll move to our next problem. Now we move to question number 9. That is, a man has his 5 friends. And in how many ways can he invite one or more friends to his party? So a man is giving a party, and he has 5 friends. So in how many ways, how many possible ways are there so that he can invite one or more of his friends to his party? So this is not related to any type of problem that we have discussed before. So let's see how to proceed this one.
This type of problem is something different. Like in such types of problems, we have a constraint saying one or more objects, one or more friends. So this is the kind of problem in which we have to remember that when we see one or more objects or one or more friends, we have to think of this type of problem. So this type of problem has three variations. They are written A, B, C.
So basically the basic requirement is that there should be a selection of one or more objects.
Yeah, there has to be a selection of one or more objects. So this selection, the objects. Now objects can be of different category. As in, they have first case. Let's consider the first case. First case is that we have n different objects. N different objects. Now n. What I mean by different objects is that no object in this n is same. All the n objects are different.
So when considering these n objects, let's say n boxes, okay, we have two possibilities for each object. Two possibilities are basically whether I can select the object or I cannot select an object. So I have two possibilities, and choosing one object or not choosing one object is independent of the selection of the other object. So the selection of each item can be done in two possible ways. Therefore,
so basically, like this two stands for that whether we have to include the object or
exactly
not.
This two is basically the way to see the object. Like one way is to include the object, and the other way is not to include the object.
And it is not affecting the include means whether we include first or not include first. It just doesn't affect the number of ways of including or excluding the second object.
Exactly. Basically, all the n different objects are independent. The selection of the n different objects is independent of the other. So we have two. So the number of total ways to select zero or more objects is 2 to the power n, which is basically 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 n times. So we say 2 to the power n. But okay, here we are considering one or more objects. So we subtract the case of say when we considered that none of them were selected. So that there was one case when none of them would be selected. So we subtract one.
Okay, so if we consider 0 or more, then the answer would be 2 raised to the power n.
Exactly. If we consider 0 or more, then answer would be 2 to the power n. But here we are considering 1 or more, so answer is 2 raised to the power n minus 1. So this was for, here we have the formula 2 to the power n minus 1. So this was when n different objects are there. What about when we have more of we have n identical objects. These were n different. What about when we had n identical objects? Let's say all these we say that we have n boxes, is n identical boxes. So how can I select how can I select one or more objects from these n boxes, these n identical boxes? So I can take one object, one box from it. I can take two boxes from it. I can take three boxes from it, or I can take all n boxes from these n boxes. So basically, I have n possible ways of selecting one or more objects from these boxes, from these n identical objects. So our answer comes out to be n, which is the formula we have.
Okay.
And the last is basically the more generalized form of these both cases, the selection of one or more objects from objects which are not all different from each other.
So like now some of them might be different, some of them might
exactly
be like
some of them might be different, some of them might not be different. So this is the third and the most generalized kind for these kind of questions. So let us consider, let us say we have P alike items, Q alike items, R alike items, and then we have N different items means that all these let's say these are N boxes. So all these N boxes are different. No two boxes are alike.
Okay, so P itself are alike, Q itself are alike, and
P stands for, like, we have P boxes, and all these boxes are same.
Okay.
When saying Q, I mean that we have Q boxes and all of them are same. Okay, so now when we consider such cases, this is basically done in two parts. From the selection of one or more items from P parts can be let's say zero or more. We can take none of them also. So when assuming this, we say the selection from P identical objects can be done in P plus one ways. Now in the previous step, the B part, we had considered a formula N. But that N formula was for one or more objects. Now I am considering zero or more objects. So I have added one to make sure that I don't miss the case when no object is taken from
these
people.
Okay, so that's an important step. You have to remember that whether the formula is for one or more objects or zero or more objects.
Exactly. Now I was considering zero or more. The same goes with Q. There were Q items, Q alike items. So the formula for choosing zero or more objects from Q alike items will be Q plus one.
Okay, so proceeding the similar manner, we'll do it for alike
R,
objects.
Exactly. We have R alike objects, so we have R plus one. And we multiply the three, because we have to find the total number of ways, and by the multiplication principle we can say that the total number of ways we'll get the total number of ways when we multiply these three.
Okay,
but now we are left with the rest n objects. The number of ways to select zero or more objects from n different objects was 2 to the power n, as we had seen previously. So we multiply it by 2 to the power n. Now these are the ways of selecting zero or more objects from P plus Q plus R plus N objects.
But we have to select one or more objects.
Exactly,
so
we have to select one or more
objects.
We
have to subtract one from it.
Yeah, we subtract one from it. We subtract the case in which we have selected, in which there is no object selected. So this is the formula we get. So when considering the question, the question says a man has five friends, and in how many ways can he invite one or more friends to his party? So we have to identify which type of case. Yes, he's right. It is case one, because all his friends are different. No two friends can be same. So all his friends are different, and he has to invite one or more. So the formula is 2 to the power n minus 1, where n is 5, because he has to invite 5 friends. So the answer would be 2 to the power 5 minus 1. But this question can also be done in a different way. Like if I can invite one, or I can invite two, or I can invite three, or I can invite four. So the number of cases will be out of five, five, C one when I select one, when I only invite one friend, five, C two when I invite two friends, and adding all the three, I'll get the same answer as previous.
So basically, we have seen that now we can. We have learned the technique of doing the problems in which we have to select one or more objects. So there are three cases. First of all, when all the n objects are different and we have to select one or more objects from them, the formula is 2 raised to the power n minus 1. So we have to be careful in this. If the question was we have to select zero or more objects, then we have to add one also in 2 raised to the power n minus 1, that becomes 2 raised to the power n. And in the similar way, we have discussed the case B and C, which says that selection of one or more objects from n identical objects is n, and selection of one or more objects from objects which are not different from each, which all of which are not different from each other, that is some of them are alike and some of them are different, that is the most general case. And the formula for this is P plus 1 into Q plus 1 into R plus 1, these are for alike objects, and into 2 raised to the power n for n different objects that are present in them, and minus the case in which we are selecting none of them. So basically, this is a very nice problem. So now we move to the next question.